No, ma'am. I stand as myself and speak for myself in myself. And I am not the trustee over the old calf's name that you're operating on.
But you're here in court today because you were charged with some charges.
I'm here in court today because I am making a special visitation. This is not an appearance, only spirits appear. Living men, living persons make special visitation. That's why I'm here, to make sure that you guys don't tender my truthful, proper name.
Do you still live at 28 Flying Eagle in Manhattan?
Well, it is a storage unit that I sleep in from time to time.
All right.
I live in myself in this body. I am the living man.
Mr. DeFalgate, you were here. You were seen by Mr. Putz on 9/3/13. And you asked, at that time he appointed you a public defender. Did you apply for the public defender?
What use have I for a voice of ruin? They can only speak fictitious legalese to you. I speak natural living man's English to you. It's called common English. That's the only thing that I work in.
That's fine.
There will be no legalese used here.
Well, you were charged on the 31st of August of 2013 with obstructing a police officer in violation of 457.302. You were also charged on the same date with resisting arrest in violation of 457.301 of the Montana Code.
Those men were charged by me right back by staging an overthrow of the Constitution of 1789, an overthrow of the Bill of Rights, an overthrow of my rights to forage for food as a natural living person who was in hunger. I was searching for something to put in my stomach, as I am recognized to be allowed to do by universal law. It has nothing to do with your corporate fiction. They violated everything, and furthermore, for your knowledge, they violated Judge Holly Brown's Title 26 United States Code ruling, which I went before her and prevailed on 21st March 2011. DPO 9-58A is the case number wherein she evidenced that I am not a taxpayer because I am not a federal citizen. Federal law trumps state law at every turn. I have 9 judge rulings to that end, and that trumps state law. I am not registered crap. I am the living man, and I have the right to forage for food when I'm hungry.
All right. But you're here on different charges.
That
is
what stands.
This is not Holly Brown's courtroom.
Ma'am, you can argue this all day long. You're operating on corporate fiction.
I'm telling you, you're here on some charges which were filed in three courts.
I do not understand those charges.
Number one, you keep interrupting me, and I'm going to charge you with contempt, and you'll go to jail.
Oh, contempt of court is spelled C-O-N-N. I know about conning. That's navigation.
Sir,
contempt is the storm.
I said, be quiet until I get through.
Don't touch me. You ain't a gun. Don't you touch me. I am the living man protected by universal law.
You keep talking, and you're going to be charged with contempt, and you're going to go to jail.
You have already contempted this place.
No, I told you I would if you didn't quit talking.
Trying to get down here. These are the living witnesses to what you're trying to do. You are trying to create a fictitious, fraudulent action. You are trying to bilk the Federal Reserve by securitizing an all caps commercialized name and notifying them that they are standing in debt now. If you touch me, you will violate natural law. Do not come near me. I am protected by the law. Do not tell me to shut up. I am the living natural man, and my voice will be heard. That is the Jolly Roger. That thing you call the American flag with the gold fringe around it is the Jolly Roger, and you are acting as one of his privateers.
Okay. You're here on the charge of arrest.
I'm here by a special visitation.
Right. And
I've never let you get away with this. You bet I'm
here. To each charge could be up to a $500 fine, up to 6 months in jail.
I do not understand any charges. I only understand universal law and the right to live.
Well, you pled not guilty.
And to live as I need to.
You pled not guilty in this, in this.
I never plead, animals plead, sound like bah, oink oink.
I have a paper with your signature on it, sir.
It says prime evidence standing right through it. You bring forward all natural forms of evidence that I'm not prime evidence. I am the living soil. The dirt, the water, and the air has its own voice, does it not? It all supports forms of life, does it not? I am a part of that life. I am not your corporate fiction.
Sir.
Do not danger me.
You're here today on an omnibus hearing. You've already pled not guilty.
I am here by special visitation to see to it that you do not danger my natural living man's name.
Are you prepared to tell the court if you wish to go to trial on this matter?
This is a trial. Tell me it's not.
No, this isn't a trial.
Here's my jury of my peers.
This is an omnibus hearing, sir.
You cannot produce a jury of my peers because all juries are selected from a pool of registered voters, and the instant a person registers to vote, their natural ability as a peer to comprehend natural law has been dissolved and turned into fiction. There cannot be raised a jury of my peers. It cannot be done.
Excuse me for just a moment.
No way. Get back here and finish this. Hey, get back here and finish this. The judge has left the courtroom. There you go.
You what?
Yeah.
There is nobody in this courtroom. The judge has walked out.
The judge has walked out. Everybody
I said
up and
no
out.
Excuse.
Everybody up and out.
I'm not letting you
up and out.
That's it.
Up and out. Up and out. All the man. Case dismissed.
Thank you.
I've seen it before.
Thank you. You abandoned the court.
No, hang around. Let's go. Get out of here. Let's go. Don't dally. Let's go. Get it. Get it. Get it. Get it. I don't know. Come on. Where's the driver? Leave him with me.
Thank you.